my first real six string. Bought it at the five and dime. Played it till my fingers bled. Was the summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Jody got married. Should've known we'd never get far.
Okay. Hi. Today we are going to cover review for quiz 7, sections 7.6 through 7.8. And I'm going to start with this problem right here. It says, does the rule y equals negative 2 times 4 to the x represent a linear or an exponential function? There's not much work to be shown here. This is straight up an exponential function. The reason it's an exponential function is because the variable is in the exponent. If it was linear, it would be more like something would be y equals 2x plus 3. You know, there's a exponent of 1 on the x and a 1 on the y that makes it linear. This one, however, is exponential. And that's it. I can make more out of that than it is. Next one. I got 5 problems for you guys today. This one, does this table represent linear or exponential form? Remember, the x column doesn't really matter. That usually just goes up by ones. It's what's going on in the y column that will determine whether it's linear or exponential. Linear is where you're adding or subtracting over and over again. Exponential is where you're multiplying or dividing over and over again. So, you know, you could, if you had any doubts, you could go, what's 15 divided by 5? What is 45 divided by 15? What's 135 divided by 45? In this case, you'll find that they are all 3. Or maybe you wanted to just look at the numbers and go, I multiplied 3 to get from 5 to 15, from 15 to 45. Either way, that's going to be an exponential function. Next one, number 3. So now we're getting into the population stuff. There's population of cheetahs has 2,500 and decreases by 15% per year. How many cheetahs are left after 10 years? So this is one, it's not compound interest, so because there's nothing about interest rates, there's nothing about compounded monthly, so you know you're going to use the other formula, y equals a times b to the x. Where A is the initial amount, which in this case is 2,500, and B is going to be the growth rate now, or the rate that it decreases by. Now, there's two different kinds. The first thing is, you have to turn that 15% into a decimal, which would give you 0.15, okay? Now, that's not what I'm going to use in this case. Remember, if it's increasing, you would add 1 to it, and if it's decreasing, you subtract it from 1. So this is going to be 1 minus 0.15, which is 0.85. That's what B will be. So when I plug these in, I get 2,500 times 0.85 to the x will be the number of years, which in this case is 10, right? And now you're going to punch that in your calculator, remembering you want to go 0.85 to the 10th power first, which is 0.19687, et cetera, et cetera, times 2,500. Then you're going to have to round off to the nearest cheetah, which in this case is 492. Cheetahs. That's the answer. Next one. Number 4, write an explicit formula for the geometric sequence. A of 1 is negative 4, A of 2 is 24. A of 3 is negative 144. So you might see it written that way. That just means that the first term is negative 4. The second term is 24. The third term is negative 144. It's just a different way of writing it. So don't be thrown off by that. Okay, so I need a couple of things in order to get the equation. I need, this is the form, the equation for that one is a of n equals a of 1 times r to the n minus 1. I'll give you that on your test. You can also write it on your formula sheet, which means I need two things here. I need a of 1 and I need r. And I'm going to leave the n as it is. A of 1 will be the first number in the sequence, which is that one. R is what's called the common ratio, and you can find the common ratio by taking two sequential numbers, or take the second number and divide it by the first number. I could also have taken the negative 144 and divide it by 24. That will also get me there, which is negative 6. So my answer is going to be this: a of n equals negative 4 times negative 6 to the n minus 1. And that is the explicit formula for that. And then you can find out anything you want. If they said, gee, what's the 22nd number in the sequence? You could plug in 22 for n, take negative 6 to the 21st power after you subtract 1 and multiply by negative 4 and get your answer. All right, next one, open response question. You owe $5,200 on a credit card that has an interest rate of 16% compounded monthly. Compounded monthly is important, 16% is important, $5,200, that's important. Okay, now, they're asking me to write an equation for the value of the credit card as it grows. Now, this is, you know, the compound interest formula. It says compounded monthly. That should have tipped you off, which means I'm going to use this equation here. A equals P times 1 plus R over N to the N times T power. Okay, so let me start filling in some of these values here. I would like to know what each one of those things is. P, R, N, and T. And if I can fill them in, I will have my answer. So principal is the amount of money you started with, which was $5,200. R is the interest rate, which is 16%. Remember, 16% is not what you use. You always use the decimal, which is 0.16. Divide by 100, move that, or move the decimal point 2 to the left. N is how often it's compounded per year, the interest is compounded per year, which means it's monthly, which means there are 12 months in a year. T I don't have yet, so I'm going to leave that part blank. But if I write my answer now, this would be the part for A. A equals 5,200. Times 1 plus R is 0.16 over N is 12 to the 12 times T or 12T. And that is the equation for the value as it grows. Okay, next, they give me T now. They tell you how much money altogether will you owe after 1 year, which means T is 1. So now I'm going to take that same formula. 5,200 times 1 plus 0.16 over 12 to the 12 times 1, which will be just 12 in the exponent. All right, now you start punching in your calculator. If I take the 0.16 and divide it by 12, I get 0.013333. And then if I add 1 to that, you get 1.013333. And then do the exponent to the 12th power, which will give you 1.17227 approximately. And remember, the last thing you do is multiply by the 5200, which gives me $6,095.81. So that is how much is in the total amount. The last part of this question is, how much money just in interest will you owe after 1 year? So, you know, this is where I started with 5,200. And then at the end, I owed $6,095.81. So if I subtract the original amount that I had, I will get my answer. I'm going to run out of space there. And the total answer is $895.81 if you round off. Okay. And that would be the last answer to the problem. And that is the end of it. So that's going to be it for the review. I'll close it out with a little bit more music. Enjoy.